For case four, we have a 49-year-old woman with confusion and hallucinations. I'm just going to scroll through several images here. These are axial diffusion weighted images. I also have a couple of axial FLAIR images. This is the end of the images. Your first question is, what is the patient's diagnosis? The second question is, are most cases of this disease spontaneous, infectious, or familial? In this case, what we're dealing with is an MRI of a patient with creutzfeldt-jakob disease. This is a prion-associated disease. This is a transmissible disease, so these prions induce abnormal protein folding in other proteins. When you're exposed to the prion, you have a very long latency. This, once it occurs, is rapidly progressive with a very short survival time. The symptoms that you typically get are rapidly progressive dementia. So if you have a progressive dementia in a very young patient, then you should think about that. The imaging findings that you'll see, we'll review them a bit more in just a second, but you typically have T2 and diffusion abnormality in the basal ganglia, the thalamus, and you sometimes have a cortex abnormality where the cortex is hyperintense, known as cortical ribboning. These signs which are associated with it, the pulvinar sign and the hockey stick, we'll take a little bit closer look at with the images. The vast majority of these cases are spontaneous in that the abnormal protein occurs spontaneously and then transmits within an individual person, with very few of them being infectious, despite the fact that that is what's in the news most commonly. The vast majority of these cases are infectious. Some people have a familial protein, which is more likely to fold into these abnormal proteins, and that makes up the other 15%. Here you see these diffusion-weighted images from our case. So what you have is this abnormality in the putamen, the caudate, and then the medial and dorsal thalami here. And then if you look a little higher, what you see is this abnormal diffusion hyperintensity along the cortex, which can also be bright on T2 or FLAIR. Here you see the axial FLAIR-weighted images that I showed you. Again, you see the T2 or FLAIR abnormalities in the same areas. Then you also have T2 hyperintensity in the pulvinar nucleus of the thalamus, and then also the medial aspect of the thalamus here. The reason you call that the hockey stick is because the abnormality in the thalamus is shaped like a hockey stick.